Hero Dash electric scooter launched at ₹62,000. Hero Electric has inducted a new product into its portfolio, the Dash. The Dash has been priced at ₹62,000 and is powered by a 28Ah lithium-ion battery which takes 4 hours to get fully charged. The fully charged battery has a rather lowly range of 60 km. According to Hero officials, the Dash is targeted for commercial purpose and short distance rides. So the 60 km range of the scooter will not matter much. Standard features of the Dash include LED headlights and DRLs, USB charging port, digital instrument cluster, tubeless tires, and remote access to the boot.
Many Tata Harrier buyers had already said that addition of a sunroof would make a huge difference to the appeal of the car. The sunroof is already a fan favorite in India across all car buyers and especially in the segment Harrier Falls. Now Tata is offering sunroof as an official accessory with the Harrier for a price of ₹95,000 plus installation charges. The sunroof would be available as part of the Tata Motors Genuine Accessories lineup. The Harrier's electric sunroof 8300 will be manufactured by Webasto, and existing Harrier buyers can have theirs fitted from their nearest Tata Motors dealership. Tata Motors would give 2 years warranty on the sunroof from the date of installation.
After showcasing the Livewire, Harley-Davidson launched its limited edition BS6 compliant Street 750 in India at ₹5.47 lakh. So the BS6 version is only 13,000 more expensive over the standard BS4 version. This is a limited edition bike which has been launched to celebrate 10 years of Harley-Davidson in India, and only 300 units of this bike will ultimately be produced. With its launch, the Street 750 becomes Harley's first BS6 compliant bike in India. In the near future, Harley will launch BS6 compliant version of the standard bike as well, but the date of the launch and pricing of the bike has not yet been announced. The first production electric bike from Harley-Davidson has been unveiled in India. The bike is called Livewire and it makes its debut in India after almost a year it was showcased in the US. The battery-powered Livewire can do 0 to 100 km per hour in just 3 seconds. Most important feature of the bike is its 4.3-inch TFT display and Bluetooth connectivity. Other features include IMU-assisted ABS, traction control system, and 7 different riding modes. Battery of the Harley-Davidson Livewire takes around 12.5 hours to charge fully using an AC socket. But the same time comes down to 1 hour if a DC fast charging option is used. On a full charge, the bike has a range of 235 km within city and 113 km on highways. The all-new Renault Triber has been launched in India starting at ₹4.95 lakhs and going up to ₹6.49 lakhs. 4 variants of the car with a single engine and transmission option has been launched. The Triber is powered by an upgraded version of Renault's 1-liter BR10 3-cylinder petrol engine and gives a peak output of 72 HP. The engine has been mated to a 5-speed manual gearbox. The engine right now is BS4 compliant but will soon be upgraded to BS6 standard and will also get an AMT option. On the inside, the Triber gets an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system compatible with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, a digital instrument cluster, a cooled center box, AC vents in all the 3 rows, and keyless entry. Other features include KED DRLs, projector headlights, power windows, and a rear wiper. Safety features include 3-point seat belts on the 3 rows, ABS, reverse parking sensor, and 2 airbags. A more luxurious version of the Volvo XC90 Excellence is set for launch. Called XC90 Excellence Lounge Console, the car would be launched in India on 3rd September. The XC90 Excellence Lounge Console would feature a three-seat layout. The front passenger seat will make way for a powered unit, which would consist of a foldable touchscreen, a leg rest, and a lockable compartment. Since Volvo is referring to the Excellence Lounge Console as a limited edition work of art, we therefore believe the car would be available in limited numbers. The XC90 Excellence Lounge Console will be powered by a T8 twin engine that powers the XC90 Excellence as of now. A flagship turbo model of the Porsche Macan has been revealed. The model is all slated to make its global debut at the Frankfurt Motor Show in September. The Macan Turbo S gets significantly more power compared to the Macan S, almost 10% more power to be precise. This increase in power comes through a new 2.9-liter twin-turbo V6 engine, which replaces the older 3.6-liter unit. In fact, the Macan turbo engine is the same used in the Porsche, Panamera and Cayenne. With all this power, the Macan turbo clocks 0 to 100 km per hour in about 4.3 seconds with a top speed of 296 km per hour. An all-black Harrier is on its way from Tata. Likely to be named Tata Harrier Dark, is on its way. The car will sport a unique Atlas black exterior color scheme with 17-inch black stone color wheels and an all-black front and rear skid plate. On the inside, the all-black theme is carried with a black stone dash, with the central console getting grey inserts in place of the four wood trims on the standard Harrier. It will also get premium Benek Calico Blackstone leather seats along with contrasting door pads. Apart from these changes, the Harrier Dark remains identical to the standard car with mechanical or any other changes made to the car. Hyundai has launched the Grand i10 NIOS in India starting at Rs 5 lakhs. Compared to the standard Grand i10, the Grand i10 NIOS gets a number of cosmetic and mechanical changes. The i10 NIOS will be available in 4 different trims across 10 variants in total. The 4 trims are Era, Magna, Sports and Esta. While the Era and the Esta trim will be available only with manual transmission for both petrol and diesel models, the Magna trim will have both manual and AMT, while the Sports trim would have all the three transmission options, manual, AMT and dual tone. The Sports diesel variant will have only AMT. Design-wise, the Grand i10 NIOS gets modified headlights and LED DRLs on both sides of the front grille, while overall silhouette of the car remains the same. On the inside, the car gets a new 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system compatible with both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. The 7th generation of the much popular BMW 3 Series has been launched in India at Rs 41.40 lakhs. The car was codenamed G20 and will be available in both petrol and diesel engine options. The new 3 Series is based on the same CLAR platform on which the BMW 5 and 7 Series is built. Design-wise, the car has U-shaped LED DRLs with a bigger kidney grille. At the back, the rectangular L-shaped taillights also showcase a departure from traditional BMW design language. The new 3 Series would be powered by either a 2-liter turbocharged petrol or diesel engine. The petrol engine puts out 258 HP, while the diesel makes 190 HP of peak power. Both the engines would come mated to an 8-speed automatic gearbox.
Hello.
Hyundai Nexo becomes first fuel cell car to pass safety tests. So Hyundai has become the first car maker to get a fuel cell powered car tested by Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. The car is called Hyundai Nexo and it was given the top safety pick award by IIHS. In fact, testing the Nexo was also beneficial to the IIHS as it offered it an opportunity to try it out its fuel cell testing technologies and thus gaining experiences in the field. The car scored huge in its safety test norms, getting excellent ratings in all 6 crashworthiness tests. Frontal crash prevention scored superior rating. The vehicle has a forward collision warning system which prevented it from collision at 12 mph and 25 mph during the tests.